All right, I'm here at Cobra Nightclub Toronto with the one and only Pablo Ceballos. Thank you for joining WLP again, buddy.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, man. You just came off you're in 11 dates in Ibiza this year, you and Chus.
Yeah, we just came from 2 weeks ago. We play at the Space and Bora Bora, and we have another date at the Space too in 2 weeks. Yeah, we have many dates this year. We're happy. Ibiza is the place to be, you know? It's like the center of the electronic music in the world in the summer, yo. So.
What about Toronto?
Yeah. Happy to be there that often this year, definitely.
Well, we're happy to have you back in Toronto, bro. You've said to me before that this is sort of your third home outside of Spain and Montreal. For the people who don't know and big fans like myself, how did this all start for you, bro, from a DJ perspective? Where did going way back in the day?
Okay, I started with Chus like 17 years ago. Long time ago, eh?
Going back to 94.
Yeah, when we started, like, nothing happened in Spain. We were like just pioneers, you know. We do music for the love of music, and we don't have any idea of what's going to happen in the future. You guys like do music for fun. And one day we started in the studio, and from the very, very beginning, like, things start to happen, you know.
Definitely.
And things start like growing. We start like to license our tracks in international labels. Then we start with the stereo and we have a really good beginning. Then we start like touring around, and then we start like confirming residencies all around the world. And then finally we were like have a very solid position in North America, especially in the States and in Canada. And finally, 4 years ago I moved here. I moved in Montreal, so I'm half Canadian. So Canadian is my second home. Canada is my second home.
Awesome. So I guess fast forward to 2001, yourself, Chus, and your manager Carlos, you started Stereo Records. How did it all come to play?
It was like a normal step, you know. We were like doing a lot of productions. We have our own sounds, and we were like licensed a lot of stuff and doing remixes. So I think it was very natural to start our own label. So that way it happens like that. And the other thing is that we have a big group of Spanish producers and Portuguese producers around us that were like super talented. So we want like support and new talents too. That's what the reason why.
Okay. Fast forward, I guess, again to 2012. Here we are, Dramatica. You just started this a sub-label as well as a podcast. What's the reasoning behind that? And where is that going?
It's just my playground, you know. It's like just a place to do whatever I want when I have some free time, you know. When I have some free time in the studio and I want to do something like personal, something very intimate, I just do something with Dramatica. That's why.
And I guess here we are in 2012. There's so much going on. Where do you guys find time to actually produce? I mean, with so many gigs, so many nightclub gigs and so much going on, where do you find time?
No, it's hard, you know, it's hard. I wish to be back in the day when we have a lot of free time in the studio and be very focused in the studio and to be in the studio for a week, you know. But that's impossible, you know, today. So we have to, like, be very, like, productive and work literally everywhere. So if the cab like takes like 5 minutes to get late, I take out my laptop and I do something, and I work in the airports, in the pool, in the hotels, everywhere.
Awesome.
Everywhere.
Where would home base be in terms of your home base studio? Where you get most of your work accomplished?
Yeah, Montreal and Madrid.
Okay.
I still have my apartment in Madrid, and I still have my studio with Chus in Madrid, and I have my place in Montreal, and I have a small studio in Montreal too.
Okay. Quick, rapid questions right now. Best sound system you've ever played on?
Back in the day, stereo. Back in the day, when it was like completely analog, like the first stereo in Montreal, yeah.
Favorite club you've ever played at?
Stereo and Space in Miami.
And
Ageha in Tokyo too. It was an amazing place.
Your studio burns down, you have nothing left, no records, anything. If you could keep one track, what would it be?
If that happened, I would kill myself, so I wouldn't recover any track. Good question.
I guess favorite song of all time?
I have many, you know. I always say that the DJ has a favorite song for this time, for this space. You know, that's the work of the DJ, to find the favorite song here and in this time. So it depends on the place I have favorite songs. It's difficult to only pick one. Yeah, it's very difficult, yeah.
Okay, fair enough. Is there anybody you're looking to break as an artist that's coming up in the Stereo label?
Yeah, definitely David Herrero. He's the new talent. The guy is super talented. has been working like for 10 years very hard. I know it's the right time for him right now. I think he played at here in Toronto recently.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we're going to get you inside in the club. We're going to have some, I guess, an extended set. We're going to get your whole footage of your entire set. Hopefully, we're going to see some crazy shenanigans, some new promos maybe coming up. Definitely looking forward to seeing what's going on inside, bro. Always a pleasure. Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you,
Pablo. Pablo Ceballos, ladies and gentlemen. WLP, What the World Podcast. Check out. Where can we catch you next?
We're going to play in the West Coast. We're going to be in LA and in Vegas.
Okay. Marky?
Marky Pool. On Saturday. I will.
Okay. Pablo Ceballos, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks, bro. Thanks, guys.
crystal pills, unreal, the thrill they yield until they kill a million brain cells.
So With the rhythm, with the bass,
We laugh, we play, we skip. So for all you hip hop